Greetings, I'm Demonac, and it's arena time.
Alright, that last game didn't go too well. I got outfatted. If I get outfatted, I don't have a lot else going for this deck, so, bleh. Opponent had spells to finish the job. I did not. But 2 wins, 1 loss is an average sort of place to be at this stage. It's whether I can get some more wins in here.
Jaina!
You asked for it.
Victory or death!
Okay. Wow, Execute is a great card. It's kind of wasted on my starting hand. I need to draw things that are castable ever. Last game was also more representative of my deck in terms of not having anything castable for a long, super, super slow start. It was against a slow opponent, which meant it was deceptive, because it was like, oh, it feels like I'm not doing too bad. That's because my opponent's not doing anything, because their deck is a better slow deck than mine. So I could coin this out. It's just a 2-3, though. No charge, no anything. I think I'm just going to play it normally. I'm going to coin out a 4-drop on turn 3. This guy is pretty poor, since I have a hard time making him cheaper. He's usually just an expensive bear. That doesn't work out great, but we're going to do it anyway.
My work is paramount. Leave me alone.
Okay, no dragon. That's good. Interesting. So I could just bash this guy and stop his freezing ass. Save my coin, I guess, because I do have big things.
For the dragon queen.
Of course, I don't actually have weapons, so freezing me isn't actually that big a deal in all likelihood, but I also didn't like it killing this. Like, I just think getting it dead was good for me. Okay. I do in fact have an Arcanite Reaper. Well, that changes things. Make it look like I had a plan. Making it look like I had a plan. Yeah. Spider Hank, okay. Shoot that, yeah. Pretty understandable play there. And she'll die too if I kill that with her. However, it would leave me with a pretty large minion here.
You're in trouble now.
I guess I go for the board clear, even though something better could be done with this axe potentially. Having no enemy minions alive is pretty good. If she has a fireball, she could clear my board, and that would be unpleasant, but even starting from scratch might not be the worst. Polymorph, okay, well, you can't shoot them both. Haha. Not even quite starting from scratch. Of course, I don't have a 6-drop right now, but eh. Yeah, okay. I am not happy with that use of the turn at all, but there wasn't much better I could do. I wasn't going to waste my charge on that. Behold, given the choice, if you're not killing something important, like your opponent, better off to put out the things that don't have charge first as an investment. Now, do I play him? Because she can shoot the 1-1, or she could shoot him, but she can't do both. And if she's trading him, she'd probably not be too happy. Plus, I still have the taunt out there, like another taunt, so she shouldn't be able to get to him. So that's pretty good. Because otherwise, I could try and kill him with this stuff. That's not going to be really expensive. I guess I play this guy, and then I Defender of Argus him and the sheep. Now I've got 6 attack, and I kill that, and I've just got a 2-3. And no, let's just do this. This guy's cool. And Flamestrike won't actually quite get through this. Like, it's inconvenient for her to try and get through this crappy board. Okay. Not a great sign. But that's okay. What else are you doing? That's the question. Because this guy can kill that now. It'd be awesome. Did it break? I think it died. Okay. Yeah, that's pretty annoying. Well, first things first, we're definitely killing that guy. Maybe I should have done the thing where I buffed with him, actually. That probably would have been smarter. Oh, well. Yeah. Too late now. We'll just sort of whittle my horn down with annoyances. She can shoot the beetle, and then she can freeze my, like, big guy. But that's not the end of the world. Okay. We're just gonna army fight. I am okay with playing army fight, I think. Now, I kill that with him. That's gonna happen anyway. I don't have a better way. I mean, I guess I could use him and the sheep to kill that and then hit for 7. That's pretty scary, actually. Then playing him not gonna work out great, but then I can still play him. Actually, that's pretty good. Yeah, okay, let's do it that way.
No.
I wanted to play this, but I guess we're gonna do it the other way. Using my force aggressively. So what she has on the board can't stop my 7-7 from killing her. Now, I'm sure she's got other things. She is pyroblasting the not me. Usually a good sign, although she is going to regain control for sure. She's not in great place, though. I could armor up, but I would rather have another chance to kill her. I could have done one more damage by buffing that guy, but one more damage wouldn't have helped. If it's not going to kill her,
you win.
Be more efficient. Okay. That went well. Crazy beetle guy, man. Crazy beetle guy. Very fond of him, especially in the arena. I don't play a lot of warrior normally, and I'm sure he didn't get played much, but he is cool in the arena. Alright. Worthy opponent.
Garrosh versus Jaina.
You asked for it.
Victory or death!
Okay. Expensive, late game. Give me cheaper things, please. Yeah, okay. It's about as good as it's gonna get in this deck. I'm going to coin out the 3-2. Because I got lots of 2s and 3s, I might as well just play stuff. Get some damage in, or defeat an annoying enemy 2-3, or something. That's fine. Yeah, well, I'll just keep doing more damage. I was going to play this guy, but I'd rather play one that won't die to 1 damage.
Dead or alive.
Captain Random, he's giving me Unleash the Hounds. I don't know how that's going to work out. That's kind of weird. But, okay. I guess we'll play that, and get more damage. Problem is, finishing him with a bash is pretty bad. Finishing him with an Unleash the Hounds, not the worst, although it's not going to use my mana very well. I think it's acceptable. Secret bad. If I duplicate him, it's just going to make this game super random, so I'd rather not, but it's probably what's going to happen. Oh, Paladin Secret. I did not see the Paladin Secret coming. Maybe I should have, because it was a Paladin-colored secret. I wasn't even thinking of that. That is pretty impressively annoying.
Mind if I roll knees?
And I've got nothing to respond to it with. Goddamn. Not sure I could have done much else of value. I mean, I could have cast Unleash the Hounds to try and waste every possible secret it could be, but ultimately, it would have been fantastic. In hindsight, it would have been better, for sure, but... you can execute. So I could unleash Secute. Not really the ideal. What else am I going to do, though? Play him, and then he dies and doesn't give me a buff. I don't want to spend my execute that way, though. Unleash and him to kill the 5-5, and then the other guy's still out there. Maybe I just play him and go for a bigger Unleash the Hounds, because, yeah. I have a handful of tools for killing things, which is really strange. But I don't know how I'm going to make it work out in my favor. Ow. That is pretty annoying. Weaponsmith. Same position as last turn, except I'd be able to armor up this time, which wouldn't really put me ahead, considering. Yeah. Goddamn.
Try this.
I don't like the way this game is going at all. Everything is wrong. Random spell guy is wrong. Even though my spell technically repeated it. Oh. That guy is incredibly bad for me. It would have been very hard for him to not work out in her favor. But yeah, that's super bad. So, if I unleash, I'm going to have to unleash, bash, and execute just to get rid of all this crap. That's how bad it is. Now, I could bash or Wolf Rider. I should probably Wolf Rider instead, because the bash is freer of restrictions. Although, if I get taken down really fast, I might regret it. Definitely making me wish I tried to execute him earlier instead of trying to do other stuff, because I took a lot of damage that probably didn't have to. But man, I sure thought it was gonna work out better somehow. Wow, is that bad? That is like maximum bad. I could double bash him because he's that bad. If I do this, my opponent's gonna get another 3-5 in the meantime. Although I would have him in the meantime, but I mean, I could bash that and then use this, and that would leave me mana to do something else. But then
what?
The something else I would do would be pretty trivial. I'm kind of just better off double bashing him, which is sad. Or actually, I hit him with this and then bash my opponent. No, that's not working out any better. This sucks. I gotta turn this around fast. I mean, yes, I have stabilized the board position, but I don't think that my position is actually any good at all. My opponent is gonna do. Now I can't axe something this turn, which is actually kind of irrelevant, but. Okay, so I can now put him out and armor up. Yay! Hopefully my opponent has to trade a bunch of stuff to get rid of it, because there's only so much I can do about that. Next turn I can do two things, but this turn I'd be limited again to basically nothing other than this. Of course he doesn't go as far against a mage. I don't see how I'm going to be able to recover this though. Assuming my opponent keeps doing anything of value. Or possibly she just kills me. So I just have the direct damage. That's also not good. God damn it! This deck cannot get a foothold because it's like early game stuff is not efficient enough. Or alternatively, it's just that I get too much of a handful of the four cost and up stuff. I have like 10 cards that cost 5 or more. It's just too easy to get hand clogged. I think that's the real thing. That's what happened in that game. 3 wins, 2 losses, and we're into sudden death next time.
If you enjoyed this, please activate the like button. And don't forget to subscribe to Demonac Games for more Hearthstone Arena and other gaming videos.